Hello guys, today's video will be about how to install and how to use the Substance Painter light link with 3ds Max. So let's get started. Once you download the zip file and extract it, you'll find a folder like this one. To install the plugin, you need to open the Substance Painter folder and copy the HS Connect folder to the Allegorithmic plugin path. That is usually located in Documents, Allegorithmic, Substance Painter, Plugins. Now when you open Substance Painter, the plugin will be available as you can see here. Inside the folder you downloaded, you will find a folder called Max. You need to copy the three files HS Connect, HS Material UDIMS, and HS Material to the startup folder of 3ds Max, usually located in Program Files, Autodesk, 3ds Max, Scripts, Startup. After that, open the menu.txt file and copy all the contents of the file. Then in Max, access the scripting menu and click New Script. Paste the content of the file, then select all the script and drag it to the toolbar section. This will create a button that will run the plugin. You can check everything is working by clicking the newly created button. To use the plugin in 3ds Max, all you need to do is click the button you created, specify a communication port, and click Start Listening. This will allow Substance Painter to communicate with 3ds Max. Now, to use the plugin, first we need to configure it. To do it, we click the plugin icon in Substance Painter, and a window will appear. At the top, we have a pin button. If we click it, the window will always be on top of the UI. Then we have the output path. Here we define the export path for the maps that will be generated by Substance Painter. In software, we choose 3ds Max, and a new option will appear called UDIMS. If enabled, the texture sets from Painter will be treated as UDIMS, and the materials created in 3ds Max will also be configured to work with UDIMS. Then we have the port parameter. This port number must match the one you defined in 3ds Max. We also have the renderer selection. This release currently supports 4 different renderers: Arnold, Corona, Redshift, and Vray. It's worth noting that right now, UDIMS are not supported if you render with Corona. Also, due to the limitations with Arnold, the material updates won't be automatic if you are using UDIMS, as established in their documentation. Then we can define the export resolution, the file format, and the normal format. All the renderers work by default with OpenGL, except for Corona, that uses DirectX. If by any reason you want to export to a file format that is not the usual format needed by the renderer, for example, a DirectX normal map to be rendered in Redshift, the plugin will automatically do the necessary adjustments in the Material Node Network to use the right normal format, while exporting the normal map file in the format you defined. Then, we can choose to either use one texture file per material map, or optimize the textures and pack more than one material map in a single texture file. For example, use the same file for glossiness and IOR in V-Ray, or use the same file for occlusion, metalness, and roughness in Redshift. Finally, we can select the bitdepth of the normal and height map, and the general bitdepth of the rest of the maps. To send the textures to 3ds Max, we have two options: either send all the texture sets, or send only the currently active texture set. In this case, I'll click Send All, and a new material is created in 3ds Max. It's important to remember that the materials will be created in the active view of the Sled Material Editor. Sadly, it is still a little bit unstable, even in the 2018 version, so you need to make sure that the Sled Editor is closed before you click Send in the plugin. Otherwise, 3ds Max may randomly crash. With the idea of keeping the plugin flexible, since there are a lot of possible workflows, the plugin requires for you to assign the material the first time. So we assign the material, and there you go, it's working. Now, if we change anything in Substance Painter, and send the textures again, we'll be able to see the updated material in the renderer. Well, that's all for now. If you have any doubts or requests, let me know in the comments or via our Discord server.
Good luck!